everybody. Good evening. Welcome to Bedford TV News on this first evening of October 2018. Happy October.
Rabbit, rabbit, rabbit. Do you know that thing or no?
Yeah, I don't typically do it, but it is my sister's birthday.
How exciting is
that? Yeah, 53.
That wasn't very, you're supposed to say 21.
Oh, no, no. I put up with a lot. She gets her age announced on TV. Debbie.
Happy birthday to Debbie.
Debbie. Yeah, we're Debbie, David, and Dawn. Isn't that cute? Oh,
that's cute.
Yeah.
You're 3D.
We are 3D. Oh, my gosh. Well, welcome to those watching live on my sister's birthday on Monday night. And remember, the news repeats on Wednesday and Friday nights on Comcast Channel 8 and Verizon Channel 38 at 6 p.m. It's also available all the time on youtube.com/BedfordTVMA. And as always, a big thank you to the Bedford Citizen for being the source of our news. And what exciting news we have.
We have gorillas in town.
Gorillas.
I'm just kidding. They're not gorillas.
That'd be cute.
Bears.
Bears.
In case you didn't know, because people have been on like Bear Watch. We should call it like Bearmageddon or something. They look cute, so I don't want them to think of a negative light. Picks, phone, Bedford's bears seem to be having a good time. Multiple reports of bear visitors in West Bedford came into the Bedford police around dusk last Monday. Oh, I thought we had a picture coming up. Later in the week, a single bear strolled through a yard on Old Causeway on Thursday, and then a playful pair visited Donovan Drive in Cross Springs Road to tussle with a garden hose. How sweet. He's just hanging over there. Animal Control Officer Michael Laskowski reminds residents that at this time of year, bears eat as much as they can in preparation for their long winter naps. Look at them with the hose. How adorable is that? It's not food,
so
bears.
So cute.
Yes, and they head for bird feeders and compost bins. He urges residents, I just can't stop looking at these pictures. Oh, the Bedford Farms, very cute there. And there, it looks like they're dancing. How sweet. I wonder what flavor it is.
It's like chocolate.
Maybe. I don't know. I think it's Sasquatch. I think
peanut
it's a costume.
Peanut butter would be best.
That's what I think.
Yeah.
And I don't.
What is that? A picture of a koi pond?
I'm not sure. Oh, come on. How sweet is that one? They're sweet until you walk into
Snuggle
them.
Snuggle them.
So he urges residents to bring their bird feeders inside since the seed is a magnet for the bears. They just want your food like Yogi. It's also important to keep pets inside or on leashes if out walking. Cute as these creatures are, humans are reminded to exercise caution without disturbing the bears and to notify the police when the visitors are spotted by calling 781-275-1212. I know people on social media have been asking, like, is anyone taking care of this? So if you have a sighting, don't just take a picture. Call the police, too, and we'll see what we can figure out.
Well, when you get tired of looking at bears, you can go to the Bedford Free Public Library. They are currently showing the work of artist Colleen Pierce in an exhibit called Viridi. Pierce describes her work as offering, quote, a felt experience of nature. She has created her pieces through her encounters with ecology and utilizes burnt charcoal, graphite, oil paint, and the teleprompters are gone. And paper. That was the missing ingredient. To create gestural responses to her observations. This exhibit would not be possible without assistance from the Friends of the Bedford Free Public Library. And the public is invited to view the exhibit during regular library hours. Make sure you take a trip over to the library soon, as Pierce's work will only be on display through November 12th, 2018.
It's like a Rorschach test. We're looking for the bears, and meanwhile, it's artwork.
I noticed that.
Other kinds of artwork, rustic furnishings. The Bedford Garden Club invites the public to a presentation by Frank Hamm, who has been building rustic furnishings and garden structures for more than 30 years. The program will take place at 9:30 a.m. on Tuesday, October 9th, in Fellowship Hall at First Church of Christ Congregational, which is 25 The Great Road, right here in Bedford. Hamm will demonstrate building a rustic garden trellis using natural materials that would blend into the surroundings of anyone's garden. The finished trellis will be donated to the Garden Club. That's sweet. Hamm has won numerous awards for his work, and he has been featured on TV, in magazines, and in newspapers. He has also taught workshops and given demonstrations for the Massachusetts Horticultural Society at Elm Bank. He has demonstrated at Tower Hill Botanic Gardens, the Boston Flower Show, De Cordova Museum, Danforth Museum of Art, Boston Center for Adult Education, plus many garden clubs. If you'd like more information, you can visit the Bedford Garden Club's website right below there, bedfordgardenclub.org, or call 781-275-0612.
Here's a story to tell you more about local transit. On Wednesday, September 19th, two representatives of Bedford, Lexington, and Burlington's local transit remodeling initiative, headed by consultants from Foursquare ITP, fielded suggestions and concerns from residents. This open conversation marked the beginning of a process to create a new system that excels both economically and functionally. While this meeting focused exclusively on Bedford's two transit options, the Bedford Local Transit and the Bedford Dash, similar meetings were held in both Lexington and Burlington for the same purpose. The towns of Bedford, Burlington, and Lexington are on the southern end of the busy Route 3 corridor and contain some of the area's highest concentrations of employment. All three towns have limited service from the MBTA and the ride, but each has elected to provide local supplementary bus service. The suggestions voiced by meeting attendees will directly influence the committee's next steps in the remodeling process. Until then, the presentation has been made available on the Town of Bedford's website, and the committee representatives stressed both riders and non-riders alike should fill out a brief survey, which will remain live until the end of October. Every answer is valuable, and all residents are encouraged to visit. The SurveyMonkey link is at the bottom of your screen, and you can answer each question to the best of your ability. Follow-up meetings responding to this survey and general feedback will be announced soon.
And someone's celebrating an anniversary.
Ooh,
your sister.
Mazel tov.
Just kidding. Yeah. The town of Bedford celebrated the 25th anniversary of the Minuteman Commuter Bikeway this past Saturday, September 29th. Bedford's festivities began at the bikeway source at 11 a.m., with special events dispersed along the trail as it wound its way to Arlington. Not only was there plenty of great food and ice cream, hopefully not eaten by all those bears, but visitors could also get a free bike inspection, step inside the historic B&M rail car, visit with local community groups that support pedestrian and bicycle infrastructure, learn about the future extension to Concord, and see Bikeway Haiku. You didn't know I was speaking that entire thing in haiku without pauses. From Bedford residents applied to the trail. Go ahead, count. For more information about the Haiku project, you can visit bikewayhaiku.org. Their link is not a haiku.
No, it should be, though.
You didn't write one. I'm surprised you didn't write one.
I did write one, and it was about bicyclists being nicer to dog walkers.
Oh,
I saw a sign on a college football game. Somebody was holding up a sign saying the coach was as bad as somebody who walks their dog on the bike path.
That's not
pretty
nice
harsh.
In many ways.
You know what? It's for everybody. It's not technically just
the bike path.
All right, Nick says it's called a bike path. You guys wouldn't let us have a dog park, remember?
What else is a no-no, dog?
Oh, what do you do with your batteries when you're done with them?
I bring them to get recycled. And I didn't even say that because of that I truly do.
Well, we are back with Recycling No-Nos, Part 2. And this week we're talking about batteries. Billerica. We're not talking about Billerica, Dan. Alkaline batteries. Here's some news. Of all shapes and sizes can be disposed of in your trash. This includes AA, AAA, C, D, 9-volt, and 6-volt batteries. What is a 6-volt battery? Is that those giant chunky batteries? What are they? Oh, they're little. They say they're little. Okay. Just so we're clear, we're talking about single-use batteries, not the rechargeable batteries. Per the Massachusetts Department of Environmental Protection, batteries currently manufactured in the United States contain no mercury and can be disposed of in the trash. The major brands, Duracell, Energizer, EverReady, and Walgreens, I guess is now a major battery brand, are manufactured in the United States. Other brands of batteries, like Panasonic, Rayovac, CVS, and other store brands, are manufactured overseas and will include language on the label indicating there is no mercury. Dan, what's the chemical symbol for mercury?
I know.
Nick's got his arm up and saying, I know, I know, I know. I'm sure he was the best student at Bedford High. No, Dan says M, embarrassing. What is it, Nick? Yes, Nick, it's HJ. Dan, you can't just go on your second choice. This is Jeopardy. Cadmium, CD, or lead, PB. Yes, Dan knew lead for everybody's knowledge. Batteries with this language can be thrown in the trash. You should check the package to find out where the batteries are manufactured. If a battery is rechargeable or contains lithium, you may drop it off in the foyer of the DPW building at 314 The Great Road. The DPW collects nickel cadmium, nickel metal hydride, lithium, sealed lead acid batteries, and button batteries. The batteries are recycled at Batteries Plus Bulbs in Woobin. Woobin.
That actually was a very helpful story for me because I know some people have just chucked them and I'm like, well, is that allowed or is that not allowed? You know?
And then if you Google it, it's a whole other conflicting story. Messages.
This is why you should be watching the TV news.
I love recycling no-nos. It's my favorite.
So I love not cats. So this next clip we have for you is not only something that would help people that may or may not know the periodic table, but also for those of you who love cats. So let's shoot it over to our fun video.
Wow, what was that, a cat? Katie, what are you doing in here?
Oh, I'm just polishing my trophy.
In the dark?
It's the only way to do it.
Funny, I didn't take you for being much of a winner.
Well, I'm not. I was actually voted least likely to succeed in high school.
Then what's the trophy for?
Oh, well, it's for Bedford TV's annual trivia night.
That's right around the corner, isn't it?
It sure is. It's coming up on November 2nd. Make sure you come and bring your cats.
Best BTV trivia night promo I've ever seen, Dawn.
Wow. It was. Delightful.
My favorite part of the show so far has been the 6-volt battery revelation. I've never heard of 6-volt batteries.
Me neither. But
of course,
I looked
it up right away. And
they're unicorn batteries.
I don't have one, but if I did, I would throw it in the trash.
I'm going to buy one just to throw it in the trash.
Just to not recycle it.
Does it have the two things on top that you can lick and shock yourself?
Yours does, Dawn. Other ones are spring-loaded.
Gonna look.
So we're here for sports again. Welcome to the sports report for the first day of February.
February.
Wow.
You lost a lot of months there.
Solid. I'm only a half a year off. Well, less than more. I know. We're going to start again. Welcome to sports. There it is. There's the 6-volt battery. First day of October 2018. October is very nice. Beautiful weather. Not really. It was a busy week for Bedford Falls sports team. So let's get right to it, Dawn. The boys soccer team extended its undefeated streak to 5 games. The 2-1 win over Weston in the pouring rain last Tuesday by a pair of goals from Marcus Voss and then had a 2-2 draw on Saturday against Boston Latin out at CC. The boys are now 4-1-2 heading into big games this week at Westford tomorrow, home against Waltham on Thursday, and home on Saturday against Shawsheen Tech. The boys, get this, Dawn, have already qualified for the playoffs.
Wow, that was
girls
fast.
Soccer has not. They have had a tough week, falling 2-1 to Wayland at 8-0 or 8-0 to Weston, but fought to a spirited 2-2 tie on Saturday against AB. But of interest to girls soccer fans is the fact that recent BHS grad and current freshman at Westfield State, Jen Renich, was named the Rookie of the Week in the Massachusetts State College Athletic Conference. Not surprising, and nice work, Jen. The volleyball team played 3 thrilling matches last week, beating Wayland 3-1, losing to Tewksbury. Ooh, Tewksbury 3-2 in a match that took over 2 hours. Long volleyball game.
That was long.
And finishing off the week with an emphatic win over Waltham. The girls play at AB on Thursday and host Arlington, the Spy Pondettes, Friday at 5:15. Bedford Runners did a fabulous job at the Frank Kelly Cross Country Invitational in Wrentham on Sunday.
Look at them go.
Hold on one second. That picture's pretty cool. That's actually from CC. Wait one moment. Jasper Shapiro placed first overall with a 3K time of 9:55, beating the second place finisher by 15 seconds. And three Ladybucks finished in the top 20 with Maddie and Annie Broyard coming in 15th and 16th respectively. Prior to that, the cross-country teams went to Concord, hence the last picture, and went 0-2. But Jasper won the boys' race, and Maddie finished 6th. There she is in the blue with all the Concord runners in pink to pace the girls' squad. The football team fell to 0-4 after a crushing 28-26 loss at home to the Clippers from Newburyport on Friday night. Despite being up 20-7 and 26-14, the Bucks fizzled towards the end of the game as Clippers sophomore QB Charles Kahalani threw for 2 touchdowns and ran for 1 down the stretch. For the Bucks, senior quarterback Pete Caponides finished 18-35 with 2 touchdowns and ran for another. And wide receiver Brendan Jones hauled in 9 passes for 147 yards and a touchdown in the losing effort. The football team hosts Boston Latin, and they really should win, because Latin is never that good, but you never know, this Friday at 7, looking to notch their elusive first win of the campaign. The golf team had a great week, beating Waltham and Shawsheen, but losing a close match to Burlington, 76-75, with Nick Manning and James Demio pacing the Bucks on the links. The golfers host Whalen today, travel to Latin tomorrow, and then host Cambridge Ringe in Latin on Friday. And trivia time, Dawn.
Oh.
Where do the Bucks play their home golf competitions?
By the VA.
Correct. Patriot Golf. You may not play there because you are not active military.
That's changing.
But it might be changing. It is. But that's where the boys play. And I'm not even a golfer. And field hockey lost to CC last Monday, and I have no result from Friday's clash against Weston. Sorry, why? Well, because, here's a note from me, the BHS scores and standings page has been down for like 2 weeks.
What?
So records and scores are becoming more difficult to track down, but thanks to Twitter and Jeff Hoyland, still able to cobble together most of them. The Red Sox locked up home field advantage throughout the playoffs as they finished with an all-time best 108-54 record, 8 games ahead of the 100-win Yankees. The Sox will host the winner of the A's-Yankees wildcard game this Friday and Saturday at Fenway. And from this seat, all I will say is that 100 victories is fabulous, but it's World Series or bust for this guy. I would prefer the World Series. J.D. Martinez finished with 43 dingers, Mookie with 30 homers and 30 stolen bases, and the Sox ended the year as the only team in baseball that did not have a 4-game losing streak. So we'll see how that goes. And the Patriots got back on track yesterday with a dominating 38-7 win over Miami at Gillette. And for the moment, things are okay on the dynasty meter. Now at 2-2, the Pats host the Colts this Thursday in primetime and then welcome the Chiefs on Sunday night, the 14th. As the one and only Mike McAllister quipped yesterday at a fall ball baseball game, quote, Miami always seems to show up at the right time for the Patriots. And this year, you bet that's true. Except that Gronk got hurt his ankle, so keep your fingers crossed. In other NFL news, though, I'm sad to report that due to some terrible roster management, my fantasy team fell to 2-2 yesterday, which, given my past performance, is right about where I should be. Have a great week. Go Sox. And next week, next Tuesday, we'll be talking about either the ALCS at Fenway, hopefully, or perhaps a wasted opportunity to make history. I'll take the former. Are we going to weather?
Yeah.
And now we're going to Dylan for the weather. See you next Tuesday.
So fall's here, and thankfully it's here to stay. We have officially said goodbye to those warm summer temperatures and are slowly welcoming those cool, brisk temperatures. The good news is that it might get a bit warmer before a few cold spells comes in pretty swiftly, but there are going to be 70s during the day that could stick around for the next few weeks, which is awesome. That's just it's great news. Get in those last few outdoor activities in before the winter sets. It'll be here before you know it. The only rainy weather we're probably going to have this week is tomorrow, and that's about it. Now here's the rest of the week. For tonight, you're looking at mostly cloudy skies with a low of about 53 degrees. Tomorrow, there's that rain with highs in the high 50s and lows in the mid 50s. Wednesday will be partly cloudy with highs in the high 60s and lows in the low 50s. Thursday is partly cloudy and much warmer with highs in the mid 70s and lows in the high 50s. Friday is a mix of sun and clouds with highs in the low 60s and lows in the high 40s. Ooh, very cold for the football game on Friday. Saturday and Sunday are absolutely beautiful with highs in the mid to low 70s and lows in the low 50s. That's all I have for this week. I'm Dylan for Bedford TV. Until next time, back to you, Jen and Dawn.
Thank you, Dylan, for that weather forecast. Always good to know what I should be wearing. I should probably do laundry, though, first. But let's talk about first what's coming up this week in Bedford on Monday. And it says Monday. I'm talking about Wednesday on Monday, but it says Monday. But it's not really Monday. It's Wednesday.
Oh, weird.
Yeah. Follow me here. So this Wednesday is International Walk and Bike to School Day. Join thousands around the globe as students and families walk and roll to school on October 3rd, which would be Wednesday. Because why would we read about that now? Because it would have already happened. What did I say?
Okay. Dan thinks hundreds of thousands.
Billions of thousands.
Whoa, billions of thousands.
1 million people. Okay.
Oh, on Wednesday, you can also do some learning. Ooh. A group of Bedford residents working in conjunction with Bedford embraces... That is a tongue twister. Bedford embraces diversity and the Violence Prevention Coalition are organizing support for the Yes on Three campaign, sponsored by Freedom for All Massachusetts. The campaign encourages voters to approve ballot question 3 in November to uphold existing laws protecting transgender people from discrimination in public places, such as movie theaters, restaurants, hospitals, and bathrooms. This ballot question workshop will be held on Wednesday, October 3rd from 7 to 8:30 p.m. at the Town Center in the Flint Room. Did you get your booklet about all the voting and all the voting information?
Actually,
in the mail?
I did not. No.
Oh, I got mine. Keep your eyes open.
I did get an alert just now that we are having a brief rain shower at 6:38 p.m.
So who just alerted a heads you to up, that?
My weather channel app.
Wow, that is very specific.
It's very specific. Yes, the rain will be light though. That's the rain shower.
Warning, light rain. Coming.
Yes, well,
that's helpful.
That's how people hydroplane. You need to be aware of these things. But Saturday, I don't think it's supposed to rain Saturday, but...
I don't think so either.
So Saturday will be the Free Bedford Historical Walk led by Mr. Ralph Hammond and Bedford's town historian Sharon McDonald. It will be on Saturday, October 6th from 9:45 a.m. until 11 a.m. Ralph and Sharon will walk by key historical sites and share many stories about Bedford's history, including the Fitch Tavern, the Stearns House, Blake Block, the Domine Manse, Weber Carriage House, Old Schoolhouse, Reuben Duran, and other points along the way. This should be a fun walk for people of all walking abilities, as well as families with children. I was waiting to read "and well-behaved dogs," but that's not part of this article.
Yeah, I wonder why.
The walk is basically flat all the way and mostly on sidewalks. The walk will last about 1 hour, walking about 1.7 miles, beginning and ending at the public library. Two very knowledgeable people in Bedford who know a lot about history.
And
fun fact.
Go ahead. I was going to say, did you know Sharon knows sign language?
I did not know that.
Her husband is deaf, and she can communicate completely in sign language.
Wow.
She's amazing.
I didn't know that.
I know. It should be part of the historical walk advertisement.
Fun fact about Ralph Hammond.
Oh, okay.
That he told me.
Yes.
That when you walk into, not that you should walk in her office, but if you go to town hall, because we're actually early, so I can tell this.
When you go to town hall,
Faye Russo's office, because it used to be an old schoolhouse, actually has holes in the floor that were there from when they used to nail down the school desk to the floor. So if you see a hole in there, it's not because like a mouse ate through it. The holes are actually still left over from the school desk being nailed down to the floor.
So and the children couldn't move at all?
Well, the desk couldn't move at all. They didn't nail the children down. They nailed the desk down.
Then you can't reconfigure your classroom to have small groups.
Yeah, well, I don't think they did cooperative grouping back in
I guess not.
The day back then. Yeah.
We've grown so much as a society.
We have, yeah.
All right, I'm going to go check out those nail holes.
Just knock on our door first before you go in. Say hi, Faye, and then you'll be able to see.
Then look around.
All right. So we thank you so much for joining us. Watch out for that brief rain shower today. Bring an umbrella and be careful of driving because we don't want anyone to hydroplane. So thank you all for watching Bedford TV News. Happy October 1st. Mm-hmm. And have a great week.
Bye-bye.
Bye.